The Old Way is a good movie. An excellent score by Andrew Morgan Smith and a solid supporting cast. The picture feels like a production from Hollywood's golden era without the overconfidence or self-awareness from some ironic films of this type. Simple linear storytelling, and although there's plenty of violence, the viewer is spared the gross-out gratuity that permeates most action films.
Just as you line up your shot, at the bottom of your breath, squeeze the trigger. Don't pull. Squeeze with your whole hand.
The only weak link in this production is Nick Cage. He looks extremely uncomfortable here, which may be purposeful. But I imagine that a classic tough guy like Lee Marvin or Charles Bronson could have turned this film from good to exceptional with quiet precision. One standout is the marshal played by Nick Searcy. He was a bright spot in an otherwise dark and dreary story.
I guess I just want you to understand how good a woman your mama was. She took the coldest killer that I've ever met, and she turned him into a family man.
Minding the store, raising a little lady.
That was a good thing your mama done.
My father used to kill people.
Yeah. But that was years ago.
I haven't even seen my father hold a gun.
Well, that's because he's a good man now. Because of what your mama done.
You carry a gun. Are you a good man?
I try to be.
Searcy's Marshall is a true archetype from the genre. A man that is working to usher in progress while trying to tamp down the fires of a violent past.
That little girl over there, she just lost her mama. She needs her father now. Whatever changes happen to you that woman gave you, don't let them die with her. That little girl needs the man that she knows and loves. You know, ever since we were granted statehood, this here land is now part of a new country. We got laws, we got due process. Folks just don't go around killing other folks. That ain't the world anymore.
He was a character I wanted to see more of, and this is where I deviate from a regular film review into a suggestion for Hollywood. Hollywood has been leaning on the crutch of the anti-hero trope for generations now. And to me, it's become dull and pointless. I think there's cash being left on the table by the absence of the classic hero. I believe that audiences would truly respond to it with their hard-earned dollars. To me, the tension between good and evil is interesting, as well as characters having to face adversity, when sometimes there's no upside to making the right decision. No medals and parades, possibly being run out of town, or killed for doing what they believe is morally right.
So long, Mark.
So long. It's all for nothing, Will.
Does Hollywood even understand morality anymore? It's almost as if, when they go to develop these characters, they're like childish, murderous emperors toying with its captives in a bread and circuses spectacle. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Thanks for watching.
Can't you think of another way to stop him?
We come from that direction. You stand there and get him to stop.
How?
Cry. Make him feel sorry for you.
I don't know how.